So now we're gonna get this thing moving, but there's still a couple more steps. So we have to tell the firmware here how many steps, how many pulses to the stepper motors to make it move a single millimeter. That way when we tell the head to move over like 100 millimeters, it moves 100 millimeters. It's also gotta go in the right direction. So we gotta make sure we set that up. So first thing we need to set up is our stepper drivers. So we've got our X and Y drivers here, right? What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna run these at 32 microsteps. That means typically it takes 200 steps to do one revolution of the motor. It's gonna split that up. It's gonna turn one coil partly on and the other coil partly on until it moves to the next step and step and step. And that way we get really fine resolution, really clean movement. So we've always got a little chart here, right? It's probably upside down for you guys, but not for me. So 400 would be half step, 800 would be quarter. So 3200 would be 16. 6400 is what we want. So 6400 is off, on, off, on. 5, 6, 7, 8, off, on, off, on. So see, this one is on, is down. So off, on, off, on. Okay. Oh, there we go. Cool. And now our current. So this is our X driver. This goes back and forth. It's running a slightly smaller motor, but still a pretty beefy one. I'm going to give it, I don't know, I think it's rated for up to 2 amps, so I'm going to give it one, maybe one, yeah, I'll keep it on the slowest at 1.4 here. Okay. So let's see. 1.4 is on for 1, 2, and 3. So on, and on. There we go. Okay. So we got that set up. Now why? Why is a bigger motor? So it's going to need a little, well, it's not, doesn't need, but it can use a little more current. We can get it to go faster if we give it more current. So I'm going to give it like, yeah, 2.37. Sure. And then that switch 1, 2, and 3 is off, off, on. So I want it to be off, off, on. Okay. And then we need to go back to 6400 here. So that's off, on, off, on. Okay. So off, on, off, on. Okay. So there we go. Our stepper drivers, the current and microstepping are set. Both at 32. Okay. If you wanted to go a little faster, you can set it to 16 and you get a double the speed, but half the resolution. So there are sacrifices. Okay. Next thing we have to do is tell the firmware how many steps it takes to go 1 millimeter, our maximum speeds, our accelerations, that sort of thing. So let's give that a try here. So first thing I'm going to do is plug the nano in, right? And if I remember from last video, we're on COM9, there it is. Okay, so I'm going to hit connect. And it's going to give me a message that says we're connected and happy. There it goes. Cool. All right. So to check your settings inside this, I can type in money, money here. Money sign, money sign. That's to check the registers. Okay, and it's got all these default settings. It actually has settings in there. But we'll make sure everything's good here. Those might be good settings. Those might not. So let's try this out. So first of all, a revolution of the motor here. One revolution of the motor is 200 steps, okay? It's got 50 teeth on this inner wheel, and there's 4 coils. And to go between each coil, it's 4 coils times 50 teeth is 200 steps. Okay, now we have microstepping at 32. So 200 times 32 equals 6,400 steps per revolution, which is what the labels were. It said 6,400 up there. Okay, so on our x-axis, we have a 16-tooth GT2. So the gear, the sprocket here, has 16 teeth at 2 millimeters between teeth, okay? So 16 times 2 is 32. So 6,400 pulses equals 32 millimeters So to figure out the math here, I can take my calculator. I can type in 6,400 divided by 32. Okay, equals 200. There we go. 1 millimeter is 200 steps. Okay, so that'd be our x is 200. Okay, now y is a little bit different. So we still have the same math up top, right? Because we set that one to 32 microstepping. But that one's a 20-tooth GT2. So 20 times 2 is 40, okay? 6,400 divided by 40, let's do that math. So 6,400 divided by 40 is 160. So that means 200 steps per millimeter on X, 160 steps per millimeter on Y, okay? So let's put that in here. So that's register 100 and 101. As I typed in the money, it actually labels it. X-axis travel resolution, Y-axis travel resolution, all that. So these weren't the right settings. So money signed 100, which is our X-axis travel resolution. The math we did had it at 200. Okay. Money signed 101 equals, what do we got here? 160. Okay. So that's the biggest part of the math here. The next thing is our maximum speed. So that's a little bit more. So the Arduino Nano can pulse at 30,000 pulses per second, or 30 kilohertz, okay? So we have 30,000 times 60. Because this is y-axis maximum rate in minutes, not in seconds, okay? So 30K times 60 is 1.8 million. Okay, so we take that and divide it by our resolution. Okay, so for X, I take 1,800,000. So you see how we have the comma, right? 1,000,800,000. Okay, divided by 200 equals, so 9,000. 9,000 is the max speed on our X. Okay, we'll clear this out. So 1,800,000 divided by 160 is 11,250. Okay, so that'd be register 110 and 111. So go back to Laser Gerbil here, or any terminal. You could use a terminal in Lightburn or just Arduino. But I like the Laser Gerbil because it labels it. So money sign 110 equals, let's see, what do we got here? 9,000. 9,000. Okay. If I wanted to go faster, I would have to set my resolution down to 1/16th instead of 1/32nd on my separate drivers. But 9,000 is perfectly fine, especially because I'm going to be cutting anywhere from 1,000 to 2,000. Okay. So then we have 111. Equals 11. We'll keep it at 9,000 also. That way we don't have a super fast Y, because that's a lot of weight. And we can literally rock the laser off our machine if we get our Y going too fast. So let's take a look at that here, actually. So when we move X, it's just moving this head, right? And this head is acrylic. It's got a little laser. It's got the CO2 mirror assembly. But our y-axis over there has to move, that one motor has to move the whole gantry, including everything x-axis has to run, right? So it's got a lot of work to do. So we're going to keep that in mind as we're setting this up here. So apparently I disconnected here. I moved the cable. I think I have a loose USB port. But next thing we have to set up is our 120, our acceleration, okay? So I did use a smaller tooth gear for x-axis. So I'm going to guess that 120 can equal, we'll go 1500. We'll try really fast, and if it can't quite do it, then we'll change that. And then y-axis, even though it's a bigger motor, it has a lot more to move. So I'm going to say 121 equals 500, and we'll see how that moves. Okay. So most important thing is our steps per revolution, right? even if it's going slow, as long as 10 millimeters goes 10 millimeters, we're good. So make sure you get your 100 and 101 set up right. And don't exceed the speeds for 110, 111. Now, we also have 102, 112, 122. That's for your Z-axis. We don't have a Z-axis. That's going to be for our rotary axis when we hook that up. And we'll talk about that later. Okay, so we got it, the firmware tuned. See, previous videos, we got power to our steppers. We've got data to our steppers. This is a moment here. Hopefully, it just works and we don't have to do anything. So, we haven't tested this before. This isn't like we set it up, made sure it moved, and then started recording the video. So, hopefully, we don't have to wait till next video. Okay, we do have live wire, and we have live wire here, so be really careful touching things. Okay? So, don't like touch the back of this as you plug it in, right? Make sure to grab something else. I'm also, yep, it's off. Okay? Reinspect my cables really fast. Looks good. Okay, we're gonna plug this in. No smoke yet. Turn this on. Okay, no smoke yet. Cool. I see lights on separate drivers. Yep, separate drivers have lights. Cool. Okay. So, here I am in laser gerbil, right? I'm gonna open this up. I have a little controller down here. So, let's see. It's not giving me the option to move. It's alarmed. That's all right. I'll hit money sign X to unlock it. There we go. And let's type in money again so it can read the files. There we go. And it's going to set the maximum rates over here accordingly. I'm going to move it nice and slow at like, sure, whatever that is, 3581. I just want to move 10 millimeters to the right. And we got nothing. Oh, travel exceeded. I see. So we've got some stuff left over. Oh, I see. So money sign 20 equals 0. So that's definitely left over from an old program. What else do we have? Homing cycle? Yeah, we don't want that yet. Money sign 22 equals 0. Enter. Okay. Now we have to do an unlock. Money sign X. Okay. And then let's move it 10. Oh, we told it to move right, but it moves left. Not a big deal. But it's moving about 10 millimeters. That looks about right. Cool. Okay, and let's move it up. Ah, there we go. So down is up, left is right. Not too big of a deal. Okay, so let's put a mask on that. So if you're going the wrong direction in X, you add 1. If you're going the wrong direction in Y, you add 2. So 2 plus 1 is 3. Okay, so we go to our, I think it's register 3. Let's scroll up a little bit. Make sure. Register 3 is your direction invert. Yep. So, oh, but it's already inverted on Y. So it actually should just be 1. 3 equals 1. So we're going to uninvert it on Y and invert it on X. I explained this more in setting up laser and setting up Gerbil for Arduino in another video. If you have any questions, definitely ask, because this can be confusing. But setting it to 1 should fix it here. So I'm going to, let's see, say move 50 to the right. There we go. It's moving. I hear the fan kicking up too. Cool. Move up. Move down. Beautiful. Nice. Okay. So next video, we are going to actually load up a program and watch the whole thing move. Thanks for watching.